Hi there, upholstery friends. Welcome to this week's episode of Kim's Upholstery Live, brought to you by Kim's Upholstery. Each week we bring to you a different project that we're working on in our workroom, and today we are going to start this Eastlake chair. So we're at the beginning of this project, so this is part one. As you come in to watch these lives, we encourage you to say hello and let us know where you're from. If you haven't liked or followed our Kim's Upholstery page, we ask that you do that. And if you're viewing on YouTube, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. And once you subscribe, you'll see that little bell icon that you can ring the bell, and that way you will get notified every time we post a new video content on our YouTube channel as well. So again, welcome to our Kim's Upholstery Live, and thank you for hopping in and joining us. Now, this project is an Eastlake style chair that we picked up. I don't remember now where I picked it up. I think a woman was selling three chairs and I bought all of them from her. So it's just a little random project we're doing just so that everybody can see different techniques in upholstery and different skills that you might learn for specific projects. Now this chair, let me tip it so you can see. This chair, when we got this chair, it only had four, or was it five springs, Bill? I think it was four. I think it only had four springs in the seat. I'm pretty sure it was four. So this only had four springs in the seat, and I don't know about you, but if you've ever sat in these chairs with just four springs, they're pretty squishy and they really don't give you a ton of support. And this may end up in my daughter's dining room, so we decided we needed a little more support, so I added two more springs so that it would have six, and then we did an eight-way tie. The more springs you have, the more support you're gonna have when you sit in the seat, and the fewer the springs, it's gonna be a softer seat because you figure you've got nothing along that spance except for the strings that you've used to tie your seats. Now a zigzag spring system is a whole different animal than an eight-way tie. It's definitely more of a sink into chair than an eight-way tie system, which is typically a higher quality frames or spring system rather. So again, as you come in, go ahead, say hello, let us know you're here. Let us know where you are viewing from too, which is always fun to see all the different places around the world that people come. I mean, just with our membership, we have members in 23 countries, I think the last time I checked, and 50 states in the United States. So it's kind of cool to see where everybody comes in from. So we are ready to put burlap on our chair. And I've already cut my piece of burlap. On the bottom of our chair, we used sagless, which is a polypropylene material. You can also use the jute webbing strips that you typically see in furniture, but we prefer the sagless material. It's really strong and durable, and so is the jute webbing, but it goes on in one sheet instead of multiple strips, so it goes on a little bit faster too. And you have to, again, stretch those with a gooseneck stretcher, a webbing stretcher or a sagless stretcher, because you always want your support systems underneath your springs really tight. So it looks like we have several people popping in already. Let's see, we have David, hello David, and Johnny, and Bonnie. Bonnie says, welcome back. Yeah, we almost thought we weren't gonna be here again because we were shoveling snow for 2 hours this morning. Hello Gina and Janice. And Janice, I answered your question in the community forum this morning. I'm sorry I didn't get to you yesterday. Hello. Kathy and Chris. Hey, Chris. Chris is my friend from high school. We have been friends for way too many years, since we were 15 years old. So what's that? 40 years now? Yikes, that's a long time. So again, hello everybody on Facebook, and thanks for hopping in. And those of you on YouTube, we'll get to you soon. All right, so let's go ahead and get this attached. So I've got my burlap cut, leaving a little bit of excess to go ahead and fold over and staple back on top of itself, which gives it that extra strength. And I have my 3/8 inch staples in my staple gun. So we're gonna go ahead and get that started. So let me just kind of position it, centering it, so that I know I have plenty on each edge. And as you're out there watching, we also ask that you go ahead and share this live feed with your friends, both on YouTube and on Facebook. Untangle my hose here. Come around the back of the chair. And I just want this snug. You don't have to like really yank on the burlap. The burlap is basically to keep your padding from falling through into your springs. Just watching that I don't hit my tacks that are under there. To get around these front leg posts. So what projects are all of you working on out there? I know, Bonnie, you've been doing lots of cushions. And did you ever find what the name of that chair was that you had posted in the community that you were looking for to see if anybody knew? I did not know the name of it. It was similar to a Martha Washington, but I don't think it's considered a Martha Washington. I'm not sure. So Bill and I went outside at 6 o'clock this morning and shoveled and cleared snow until about 8. Then came in and had coffee and sat down and took a break before we had breakfast and headed to work. Fold this back on top of itself. I'm going to trim a little bit off before I do that. Now we'll be using edge roll along the edges here too once we get this burlap all in place. Better? So now our burlap is just about done. Is anybody sharing what projects they're working on, Bill?
Well, I'll let you know in a minute. We do have some people in here from YouTube, but I don't know if you can see this, and I'm having trouble making it bigger, so.
No, I can't see it.
Deanna is here from Iowa, it looks like. Susan Hartman's here from Maryland. Katrina's here, Dawn, Amber. Amber is almost done with the living room armchair. Jean Billingsley's here. That's something we haven't heard from in a while. That's all over there on YouTube.
Alright, well hello everybody on YouTube. Okay, so now our burlap is in place and I'm ready to go ahead and add our edge roll. I've already cut my edge roll down and I am using, where's my little ruler here? I am using a 1 1/4 inch edge roll, so if you measure across that, it's a 1 1/4 inch. And this is the polyfiber edge roll. You can also get a burlap edge roll, so whichever you prefer. I can't say that one is significantly better over the other. This is just the one that I like to use. This one's going to be a little difficult with the angle to get on this chair. Thank you. there is our back piece. And I initialed all these so I would know exactly where they went. The edge rope will give a better defined shape to our seat. Let's see, front needs to be the side first. Just kind of bending them into shape because when they're wound up, they get kinks in them sometimes and you just need to untwist. Good afternoon to Audrey. Actually, it's morning for you, huh, Audrey? And hello, Ragne. And Bonnie says, not really. I forget my question, Bonnie. Sorry. Ragne says, working on an awesome and giant couch that has the most interesting techniques used. Audrey says, Kim, what is the clothes sewing zipper foot called that you use for the invisible zipper? Let's see, for the invisible zipper, I don't have one that is on the walking foot machine, but it is actually called an invisible zipper foot. And I use the regular, sometimes I have discovered on a walking foot machine, you can get away with using one side of your zipper foot and one side of your welt foot. So your cording foot is the center part that you use, that you can get pretty close with invisible zippers using that. And hello, Christy and Gina. Gina says, getting ready to paint an antique settee. Bonnie says, I know what it was. You didn't know what the chair was called yet. Okay. I have been so busy after the cushions. I have 10 chairs ahead of me. Good for you. That's not a bad problem to have. And hello, Carol. Thanks for coming in today. And we'll do our front piece. Now, Audrey, how far are you from Lodi, California? I forget what part of California you're in. Okay, so now our edge rolls are all in place, nice and solid. And they're pretty even with the height of our spring. So now we're ready to go ahead and start adding our padding all around the seat. You know what I didn't bring a piece of out here, Bill, was Dacron. Which I don't need quite yet, but I'm going to. I'm running off camera here for a second to grab some cotton pieces. And I use the synthetic cotton, which I'm sure most of you know that by now.
So you need me to get you some Dacron?
Yeah, probably like 28 by 28. There might be a small piece underneath the, actually maybe bigger than that. Let me get a, there's a cloth tape measure. Here we go. Okay. Yeah, 28 by 28 ought to be big enough.
Okay.
Thank you. 28. Yep. And there's a, well, you'll see, there's a chunk out there. All right, so I'm gonna grab some little pieces, because I have some little random pieces over here, and we'll fill in the lower areas first. This is my scrap cotton stash just thrown in the floor over there. So it snowed last night, and you know, I've lived in New England all my life, and it still amazes me the number of people that freak out when we have a snowstorm. It's like, if you live in New England, you expect snow. Just kind of like you, Bonnie, in Canada. You expect to have snow. It's not like a big surprise. And people just go crazy. So we got about 8 inches of snow, which wasn't too bad, but then on top of it, we got ice, which is the not fun part, because now the snow is heavy and crusty, so. Cleaning off the cars this morning took a bit because it was just frozen solid. Too much right there. For the most part, my end drill is pretty snug against the front edge of the spring. There's just one little void right here. Thank you.
It's oversized.
Yeah, I'd rather be too big than too small at this point. Feeling. Just back here's the only spot I need to add some more. Okay. I think that feels good. Now we're ready to add full pieces. Get rid of my little stash here. Let's see, how many layers do you guys think this is gonna take of cotton? Who's got a guess? Actually, one thing I need to address. Let me turn this towards the camera. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. But this chair is like so crooked from left to right. What was it, Bill? Like a half inch difference the way the seat set?
Yeah,
so it doesn't sit. The legs are good. It's the way it's all joined. It's weird. But so if you look at these front posts for the legs, this one comes up nice and flush with my edge roll, and this one is down almost a half an inch. So we're gonna add some extra cotton on here. I did consider having Bill chop this side down, and then I said, you know, let's just go with it, because if we chop it off and we do something to make damage, then we gotta fix that, so we decided to leave it.
Janice Lent says three.
Three layers, okay. Any other guesses? So I'm just gonna go ahead and staple that right ahead again.
Bonnie says four or five. Tracy Windley's here. Hello,
hey, Tracy. Oops, just blew a hole in my cotton. All right, that's pretty good. It brings it up feeling pretty level with that. All right, so we've got three and we've got four or five. I'm thinking four or five myself. I'm thinking five. But we'll find out. And it's one of those things too, it's like if you're doing this for a customer, you need to know what their desires are for comfort, but if you're doing it for yourself, you can make it any way you want.
Depends on which one of us sits on it.
This is true, too.
If I sit on it, I'm going to squash it.
Bill wants five or six layers. I like them to be comfortable, though. I want to make sure it feels like it's got a nice, soft seat. Actually, let me do it and pull this way. And right now, I'm just staying on the top. Now we've got another Eastlake chair we're going to be doing for a video for our membership site that has those braces that come out the side that has those really funky cuts that somebody was struggling with not too long ago. So we're going to make that part of the cuts video as well. Okay, that's two, and I don't think it's comfortable enough at all yet. Okay, so Audrey said she's 8 hours away from Lodi. 8 hours in which direction? Because I'm actually headed from Lodi down to San Diego. So if you're close to San Diego, we might be able to make it work. I'm gonna spend a couple days down there with another upholsterer. So that's two. Here's three. This one looks like I put it through the ringer. It's got a little tear on that side, so we'll flip it over. Sorry, Janice, three's just not gonna do it. I can tell already. Grab some more over here. Feeling three, I'm thinking we may hit six. We'll see. Four is feeling better. So how many of you use synthetic cotton and how many of you use natural cotton? And which do you prefer if you've used them both? I'm the only one I have ever talked to who's had problems with the seed pods in natural cotton, which is why I switched to synthetic, but then I really got so I liked it. We're starting to feel good. Here's number five. I'm thinking six. Grab the sixth piece and see what it feels like. And then the dacron will be our final layer, whatever we decide on here. Or since you guys can't feel it, I guess I'm gonna have to decide. I'm liking that. Six feels good. And it's still going to give me enough to pull down and have a little bit of space between the back and the seat. Now, one thing you'll notice when you see pieces like this done with the traditional upholstery method, they're very squared off, but the way most of us in the States do is we have everything more rounded, which I think is just what we're used to and the look that we like. Okay, so let's get some staples anchoring this down before we start with our dacron. I'm gonna need somebody to sweep up this mess afterwards, Bill. He's ignoring me. All right, let's go ahead and get some of this attached. And I wanna keep as much of the area where my fabric is going clear. Towards the back and get it a little bit tighter. We'll just pull the excess out from the back side. Just making sure I don't have any hollows anywhere. That's feeling good. Because if you do have an area that you're questioning in your padding, now is the time to fix it, not after you get this all stapled down. And sometimes I'll get to this point and build the corners up too, but we'll see. I'm not going to staple that corner down quite yet.
Some people seem to be having trouble finding our page to watch the live, I guess.
Huh.
A number of them are over on YouTube watching.
Okay.
But I have it on page, so I don't know. These others do, so.
So it says, so what are they, making the comments in YouTube, Bill?
Yeah.
Yeah. So sorry to those of you that are having troubles finding the page. We do have people there on Facebook, so we know it's working. You just never know with modern technology and with going live. It's always, there's always things that can go wrong, so. I'm out of ammo. See, I thought I had left some up right there beside my hand. I thought I had left some up here. All right, so I've got the two front corners still unattached because I want to make sure I got enough padding in there. So let's do this back.
Ragni wants to know, what's the official name of the white fluffy stuff?
Synthetic cotton. I like white fluffy stuff though. That sounds pretty good to me. Yeah, it's synthetic cotton is what my distributor calls it. I don't know if it's got other names, but it's in place of the natural upholstery cotton.
And we only do that because we had a bad experience at one.
Once.
A long time ago.
Yeah, a long time ago. I was upholstering a chair and I came into my workroom the next day and there was these spots on the seat. And I'm like, where did these spots come from? It was on the deck. And Bill says, well, you probably left your gun on top of it and oil probably leaked. So I'm like, all right. So I tear the whole deck off, put on a new deck, get started with the inside arms and get those going. And the next day, there was an oil spot again. And then we finally realized that it was the pods, the seed pods within the 100% natural cotton were leaving oil spots. So after that, I stopped using the natural cotton, but I have never talked to anybody else who has had that happen. And that is another reason why I started using Dacron over the top of everything. But I really like the way the Dacron makes stuff feel. It smooths it all out. And I think it's one of those things too, it's what you get used to. Some people don't like the synthetic cotton and only like the natural, and others like the synthetic more. So it just depends on how you work and what you like working with. Hello, Sandra Van Sickle, and hello, Kelly Chitty. And Tracy, we said hi to already, but hello again, Tracy. And let's see, Bonnie says, Kim, which part of Maine are you going to in the fall? It's Dayton, D-A-Y-T-O-N. I can't remember what it's next to now, if it was Portland or Saco, I forget. And Amy, Audrey says, trying to find the dates you'll be out here. I'm 2 hours north of San Diego. I'm near Los Angeles. All right, so I'm trying to remember. I think I fly into San Diego the night of the 17th, which is the last day of the class. So I will be there
in March.
I'll be there Monday and Tuesday, and then I'm flying home Wednesday morning. And I think it's the 18th and 19th that I will be there. So message me and we can try to hook up. I'll tell you where I'm going to be. That would be awesome. And Annette says, natural, just the first I started with and haven't changed. Audrey says, I've tried the synthetic one. I took classes in St. Louis and loved it, but they don't sell it out here. And that's the problem. It's like you get hooked on something and then you've got can't find a supplier. Hello, Patty. Thanks for joining us today. And she says, you mentioned the kind of paint you used on the blue settee. Could you tell me what the name of it was? Yes. Let me grab my cell phone because I took a picture of it because I need to go get some more. And hello, Debbie. I'll be in Debbie's in Rochester this summer. Let me see, it's Bear Paint, but let me get the exact name for you. It's their Premium Plus Ultra. And I tell you, it is the best thing since sliced bread. So Bear Premium Plus Ultra from Home Depot. And hello, Cheryl. And let's see, Patty says, finally found Paige at Kim Shagnon instead of Kim's Upholstery. That, are you live in the wrong place today,
though? I didn't think I was. And how did everybody else find us, on our page or on your?
I don't know. So are you guys on Kim's Upholstery Facebook page or are you on Kim's personal page? Curious. I can check on my phone.
Well, it said.
Hello, Jackie. Thanks for joining us today.
It said Paige.
It said Paige? All right. You know, sometimes with technology, we think we're doing something and we find out later it was a little bit different than what we thought. Let's see here. Come on. So now my phone won't load. Nope, Bill, I don't see it on our page. I see it not coming up here as well. So maybe it is on my personal. So those of you on YouTube, go to Kimberly Shagnon on Facebook. And that's Kimberly with an L-E-Y. And you'll find us there if we're not on our page.
All right. So Ragnar's asking if there's a weight or something.
Where I get it from, Ragnar, no. It just comes in a roll, just like your regular natural cotton does. I think it's a 16-pound roll, and it's, you know, probably about that big around, 24 inches in diameter, maybe.
Yeah, everybody's finding this on our personal page. Isn't okay. That's unbelievable.
Sorry about that, guys. That's what we get for taking 2 weeks off, huh? Not by choice, though. My back is better, though. I still have to be careful because it's one of those things I can just feel that muscle wanting to go again. But I am not one to sit still. And I literally sat on my butt all day last Wednesday and did not get off the couch. And when I did get off the couch, it wasn't fun. Bill's like, do you need help? I'm like, no, just let me do it. I can do it. But basically sitting and doing absolutely nothing for 2 days. And then it got better. And so now, like I said, I can still feel it if I move wrong, but. All right, so let's take a peek. So I don't know about you guys, but I'm liking that nice soft crown of that. So now let me just decide what I want to do with the corners. And I'm thinking they need a little bit more cotton underneath there to boost them up a little bit. So this is where you just kind of experiment. Get the feel you want, the look you want. I don't want my corners to flatten out. That actually feels pretty good on that one. But don't forget one side's lower than the other, so it's gonna take different amounts of padding to get them equal.
I'm surprised Sandra didn't tell us that she found us on the page and not on the, I mean on the personal page. And not the
well, she's saying Kim's too, so. Yeah. On my phone, I couldn't find it on our business, so. Oh well, we're here anyway, right? So it doesn't matter. You found us. Okay, this one's not. Let's see, do they feel the same? Okay, I think so. I don't want it to, if I get the fabric on and there's not enough padding in here, the corners will just cave down and it'll be harder to make them look good. So I want them to be nice and full. I think I need a little more. This was our lower side too, so I need a little bit more in there. And you want to make sure you don't ball it up and make a lump because that's not what you want either. Yeah, that feels good. All right, let's commit. Whoops. And not throw staples across the room. Okay, and now I am ready for day grind. One last time, check it all out, make sure it feels good. Sometimes I'll even take and sit them down and throw the fabric over them and sit on them. Let's actually get a measurement and cut that down. Now I think I'm inhaling cotton. Myself enough to hang on to. 27 inches. How was I estimating 28? That was pretty good. Same there. So, all right. Just shifted things so I can cut this down. Not a very straight 3 inches, but yeah, not too bad. I wouldn't suggest eyeballing it with something that was critical. Day grind, I can get away with being a little off. Fabric, you don't want to do that. Sometimes you need to be precise, and sometimes close enough is okay. Cutting day grind, close enough is okay. Put that over there for a moment. Make sure I got plenty left to right, front to back. Go ahead and get some staples in the front. Now, I was talking to somebody who was posting in the community, actually I guess it was in the Facebook group the other day, talking about getting ripples in the front of their fabric after they put their fabric on, or ripples underneath in the padding, and that's typically because your padding isn't tight when that happens. And that can make a real mess. Now, we were talking about paint a second ago. Somebody asked about the paint I used on the blue settee. On this chair, I used a Rust-Oleum, I don't know if it's chalk or chalk-like, I forget what they call it. But it was Rust-Oleum bright. And it went on really nice. It seems to wear really good. I mean, I haven't banged this chair around much like I will as we get going, but I've had no problems with chipping or anything yet. It did when I tried to steel wool it to smooth out, because I don't know about you, but I don't like the chalky feel of the chalk paint. I love the way it goes on typically, but then I went over it with steel wool to kind of buff it up, and it gives it a nice hard finish with a little bit of a sheen. The only thing I don't like with chalk paints when I do that, and I forget, somebody told me to try really fine sandpaper next time, is it actually makes lines in the chalk paint where it's, I forget what they told me that it's doing, but. This went on pretty good though, but I still have to say that bare paint is leading in what I'm liking the best. The general finishes was that bright green chair that we just did that is a video on our membership. That was that picture back chair and that lime green with the teal fabrics, teal and green fabrics. And that was the general finishes chalk paint, and that stuff was really nice. The color was really, really a, what do I want to say? Like a really saturated color. It was really good and it went on very nice. The only mistake I made on that chair, because of lack of knowing, is I used a wax on it, and I guess you're not supposed to use wax on the general finishes because they are non-porous, so that the wax just sits on top and will eventually just rub off. So I did wax that before knowing that information, but I'm liking it. It still looks really good. I'm just getting this really, really tight. Now, speaking of workshops and going to be in California, we also just opened a workshop in Castle Rock, Colorado. Again, it's a whimsical chair. This coming summer, which will be fun. And two of the ladies from the class are coming back and have signed up, and we only have two spots left already. So that one is in August. And then we have one spot left in our slipcover class, our workshop, which is in April in Houma, Louisiana, if there's anybody out there near that area that's interested in a slipcover workshop. And then we have three spots left in the Plymouth, Mass. cushion class. And then the Dayton, Florida that Bonnie asked about, we still have two spots left in that. And that is an advanced class, so you have to have done some projects already. And speaking of cushions, we just finished filming that window seat cushion, which I showed you, which is actually our living room. And that is a new trapezoid tutorial that's going to be on our membership site, hopefully in the next few weeks. Bill's got a lot of editing to do though, so. Okay, so we've got a tight front to back. And now we just kind of got these wingy things going on, which don't look very good, so I guess I need to make some cuts. But I want to make sure that I've got it tight enough and it's feeling good. So I'm going to go ahead and get a couple staples on each side, and then we'll make those cuts, and then we'll finish those front corners. And there's our friendly air compressor. Same again. And I know you can't tell, but I'm really pulling quite hard here on the stake run. And there's a fine line between pulling enough and pulling so much that you tear your date run. So you really have to kind of get a feel for how this stuff works. And someone had asked recently about using quilting batting that you can get in the stores for quilters. And that is totally different. It's not nearly as strong as the stake run. So my answer to that would be definitely not. You hit wood and not edge roll. So you do have to have strong hands to do upholstery for sure. Okay, let's check it out. Everything's nice and tight and comfy. So when did we ended up with six layers, didn't we? So that was a lot of layers, but it gave me the feel I wanted. Nice, supportive, and I think adding that extra two springs in there was huge on making this chair gonna be more comfortable. So now let's go ahead and make the cuts in the back corners here so we can get our date crown under control. Everybody loves making cuts in their upholstery fabric, right? It's really not that scary. Once you get the concept down and really start listening to your frame and what you need to do. All right, that looks good. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut off some of this excess here. Get this side stapled down. Just constantly feeling how that edge is. I want to make sure it stays consistent. Anybody got any questions today? Is it just quiet, or is Bill just really busy?
It's kind of quiet, and I think that's because we're on the wrong page.
Hello, Tana and Deanna. Deanna gets to join us in Lodi because we had one person that needed to cancel out because of family health issues. So Deanna gets to join us in Lodi. And hello, Heather. Thanks for hopping in. That was a beautiful picture you put up there of that historic building that you did, Heather, that's on the, I guess it's on the market for sale, that house. It was beautiful work. And I just, if you don't follow Heather, she has the most adorable workspace. It's like, so one of these days I've got to take a trip to see you. Because she has this little stone building, and I'm hunting for my scissors. Oh, hey there. That her workspace is in. I just can't wait to see it. It's cute. It would make me want to go to work every day. Although I kind of do want to go to work every day, don't I?
You do.
We work by choice. We don't work. I mean, we work because we have to work, obviously, but it's like we come in every day, even if we don't have to. We're like, let's go putz around at work today on the weekends.
We're boring people.
All right, let's make the cut on this next corner here. Did you hear him just say we're boring people? I don't think we're that boring. Heather says, I'm watching you now with earbuds while waiting for a doctor's appointment. And Deanna says, woohoo. Hello, Janet. Because Deanna gets to join us in a little bit. Deanna was actually going to come out and have dinner with us anyway, which we've got a couple other people coming and joining us for dinner one night, which will be fun. So that's one thing I am trying to do this year when we're at workshops around the country is find out who's in that area that we can hook up with for dinner or whatever one of the nights that we're there. Some places I'm staying extra days so we can have our mini meetups and not just our big upholstery meetup. So how many of you are joining us? Did you put that poll out there to see who's going to join us for the meetup?
Yeah.
So we're having our second annual upholstery meetup this year, July 31st through August 2nd, and we are starting out in Gastonia, North Carolina. We're going to be going to Revolution Fabrics and Krypton Fabrics, which are both in Kings Mountain, which is, I think it's about a 15 to 20 minute drive in Gastonia. And we're also going to go to Rolly Company. And then I'm still working on the third day. In fact, I got a couple phone calls to make.
Sylvia's glad you found somebody to take her spot. Did you?
Not yet.
Take care of that.
Yes, and I will give you your refund, Sylvia, because we did fill the spot. I was going to email you today, actually. It's Angie there. All right, so now we have wings in the front, and those don't look very attractive at all, do they? So I'm going to go ahead and finish that off, decide what I want to do with my Dacron. I think we're going to do that. Scissors are over here. I keep peeking to make sure I'm not stapling down too low. I got a very slim margin of where I can staple. If I go too high, I hit the edge roll and they don't hang in, obviously. And if I go too low, then I don't have room to staple my fabric and have it look nice.
Gladys is working on a Parsons chair, and Claire says it's a shame you're not in the UK.
I would come to the UK. I know, it would be fun to do a class in the UK.
You drive on the wrong side of the road over there.
I would have to be a passenger then.
I was there.
That would totally throw me off.
I was there years ago, and I stepped off the curb, and of course here in the United States, you know, we look one way and not the other, and I stepped off the curb, and there's a big bus that almost took me out.
That
I caught on quick.
Yeah, I wouldn't have even thought about that crossing the street. Eh.
I
So I've left myself just enough room for my fabric, which will then get covered up with double well cord. Again, constantly feeling those corners. If you've ever had a corner bottom out at you when you get your upholstery fabric on there, you know exactly why I'm checking this over and over and over again. Because it's not pretty. And then I would be pulling out lots and lots of staples at that point. All right, so that feels good. Let's do the other corner. I'm actually going to spin the chair so it's closer to me. I had a couple of staples in there because I had a space that didn't have many staples. One side of the chair is always easier to do. I know you hear me say that a gazillion times. When you're right-handed, it's one side. When you're left-handed, it's the other side. So every shop needs a left-handed and a right-handed upholsterer. Janet says, "Hi, Kim. I've missed being able to see you." I know you've been away on vacation, and that pictures you showed of your bedroom with the curtains you did, those were absolutely gorgeous. And Bonnie says, "I would love to meet you for dinner in Maine." Well, let's see if we can make it happen. I don't know how far it is from you. It's probably a hike, though. Maybe you'll have to plan to come down. Let's see. Maybe I can make extra days and go up. Bill, would you go with me? Bill doesn't go with me usually. He stays here and takes care of online stuff. You guys can see. Okay, and then now you have to make sure your corners match. So that's the other final ruler. About three. Oops, helps if it's in the right direction. That's the same. Good. All right, they're at the same height, which is a good sign. Fold and get the same shape, and you're doing good. I think we got it.
Sandra says, "Bill, you need to get out more." I just need to listen to Kim. She's always telling me to get out.
Get out, get out. Go away. Okay, there we have our padded seat. Everything feels really good along the sides, all consistent. Nice dome shape, and I'd sit on it, but it's on a pedestal. I think I'd fall. So there you go. So we're not going to get to fabric today, but let's go ahead and get the sag list on the inside back. So 6 layers of cotton, 1 layer of dacron, and 6 springs made for a comfy seat. Hello, Joan. In fact, Joan is the hostess of that workshop in Maine, Bonnie. So Joan, can you tell us what Dayton, Maine is near, that Bonnie might be familiar with? Bonnie is in New Brunswick, Connecticut. Yeah, New Brunswick, Canada. So all right, so let's go ahead and start putting the sagless in the inside back, and then we will call it quits. Oops, you know what? I didn't trim this down. So let's trim this down. We don't have time for that? Okay, all right. So let's go ahead and trim this down. So next week, we will be putting the fabric on the seat and get our support on our inside back and hopefully get the inside back padded. So let me show you the fabrics again. So the seat is actually the same fabric I used on the green picture back chair, which is on the membership site. So this is going to be the seat. This is teal blue. And that's that outdoor velvet from Greenhouse Fabrics. I love that velvet. I've used it on a lot of things. And then our fun, fabulous floral, which will be on the inside back. I thought about getting a stripe for the outside back, but then I decided I really love this fabric too much. So this is going to be both the inside and the outside back. And the background in this fabric is actually a gray. So it works really well with the paint color that I chose for our chair. So thank you guys all for joining us here today for our Q&A, yeah, for our live that we missed 2 weeks in a row, unfortunately, and hopefully we'll be back next week with no snow, no illnesses, no nothing. But for you members, we will be live with the members only Q&A at 3 o'clock in the member portal. And don't forget, you can come in live on camera with us, but you can also just participate in the chat there if you're not comfortable doing that or you don't have a strong enough internet. But again, thank you all for joining us today. We're glad to be back, and we will see all of you right back here next week. Thanks, everybody. That's gonna be fun. Look at that floral showing through there. I can see it on the camera. Cool.